Welcome to a video tutorial on luciferase reporter assays. This video lecture is a part of a series of BioClock Studio tutorials to help you better understand circadian biology. We are your narrators,
Victoria Nudell
and Omar Romero, and we produce this video under the guidance of Dr. Susan Cohen and Dr. Susan Golden at UC San Diego. In this video, you are going to learn about the luciferase reporter assay, a common technique utilized to study various biological responses such as circadian rhythms in many organisms.
In this video, you will learn the characteristics of a luciferase reporter, how luciferase is used in circadian biology, and the difference between luciferase reporters and fluorescent protein reporters, such as green fluorescent protein, also referred to as GFP.
We will first explain the basics of molecular genetics. The genetic information of an organism is stored in the genome, which is made up of DNA molecules. Within genomic DNA sequences, there are special regions called genes. Genes can code for proteins, which perform various physiological functions and give structure to cells and tissues. The first step of conversion from DNA to protein is transcription. Transcription is the process of making a messenger RNA, mRNA, from DNA. The next step is translation, where the mRNA is converted to a sequence of amino acids, resulting in a protein product.
Here, we will introduce characteristics of the luciferase reporter. Luciferases are proteins that catalyze a reaction to produce light using a substrate called luciferin. You may have seen bioluminescence in nature. For example, in the light emitted from fireflies, as well as bioluminescent waves created by microorganisms found in the ocean. The amount of light emitted can easily be detected and quantified.
The production of mRNA from a gene is controlled by a promoter sequence located upstream of the gene. To measure the activity of the promoter that drives transcription of a gene of interest, in this case PER2, we can express luciferase under the control of the PER2 promoter so that the product will be a light-emitting enzyme. Luciferase is expressed at the same time that the gene of interest would normally be expressed from that promoter. This is called a transcriptional fusion because the luciferase gene is transcribed at the same time as the gene of interest.
Once you've acquired a construct containing the luciferase reporter, the next step is to introduce this construct into your cells of interest. After being incorporated into the genome, the luciferase gene is transcribed to produce its corresponding messenger RNA. This mRNA is translated into an active luciferase protein, which when provided with its substrate luciferin, can then catalyze a reaction with oxygen to produce light. The resulting light intensity is measured by detection instruments, which are highly sensitive to bioluminescent light. This light production is correlated with the amount of luciferase produced, which is dependent on the activity of the promoter. So, the more activity of the promoter of the gene of interest, the more light will be produced in the cell by luciferase.
In contrast, we can also make a translational fusion, where the coding sequence from the luciferase gene is fused to one end of the gene of interest, such that when the fused transcript is translated, luciferase and the protein of interest are made as parts of the same protein. A translational fusion construct can provide additional information because the level of luciferase is equal to the level of the protein of interest.
Similarly, the construct containing the luciferase fusion gene needs to be incorporated into cells of interest. Where the luciferase fusion gene is transcribed and translated into a fusion protein with the active luciferase component, which can then catalyze a reaction with oxygen and the substrate luciferin to produce light. The resulting light intensity is measured by detection instruments to show how much of a protein is being translated at one time.
Reporter gene assays can be used to study signaling pathways, gene regulation, and the sequences that regulate a gene. Using genetic reporters allows us to have a visual cue of when proteins are being expressed, what tissues express the gene, as well as how strongly the gene is being expressed. Genetic reporters greatly simplify the process of quantifying when and in what tissues a gene of interest is being expressed, which is why this technique is so relevant to many different applications.
Once the luciferase assay is complete and expression data is obtained, this data can be used to calculate the period of the rhythm or the timing from peak to peak. the phase of the oscillation, meaning the time during the day when the gene of interest shows peak expression, and the amplitude of the rhythm or levels of gene expression for the organism or tissue.
We would like to point out the key differences between luciferases and fluorescent proteins, as luciferase fusions are usually not good at resolving where within a cell a protein is targeted. For this, a different kind of reporter or a fluorescent reporter is used. Luciferases do not require an external light source, but require a substrate, luciferin, to emit light. They generate light called bioluminescence through the enzymatic luciferin-luciferase reaction. On the other hand, fluorescent proteins do not require a substrate, but require an external light source to emit light. They absorb light of a certain wavelength and emit light with a longer wavelength. This emitted light is called fluorescence. Luciferase reporters are advantageous for quantifying or monitoring promoter activity and protein levels. They can quantitatively detect a very small amount of expression with great sensitivity, because in complete darkness, bioluminescence produced by luciferase is the only signal within the cell. However, luciferases are not as good at visualizing the location of proteins within the cell because the light produced is too dim for visualizing specific areas. Like luciferases, fluorescent proteins can be fused to a promoter or protein of interest by molecular techniques. Fluorescent proteins are brighter than luciferases and advantageous to visualize where the proteins are localized within a cell.
Here you can see an example of how GFP is utilized to show when a gene is expressed by using a transcriptional fusion to monitor expression from the Chi-A promoter in cyanobacteria. GFP is expressed when the Chi-A promoter is activated, but the GFP protein has no instructions on where to go within the cell. By using a translational fusion, where GFP is fused to Chi-A, we can see where within the cell the Chi-A protein localizes. Although GFP is good for visualization, it is not as efficient for quantification, especially when the amount of gene expression is low, as many components of the cell also naturally fluoresce and add noise to the signal. To summarize, luciferase reporters are better for quantification of the level of promoter activity, or the amount of protein being expressed, and GFP reporters are more useful for the localization of proteins.
We hope you now have a better understanding and appreciation for the use of reporters to study complex biological problems, and specifically the uses, functions, and considerations of using luciferase as a reporter versus fluorescent reporters to monitor circadian rhythms.